Hello, this is Nevis here, and I'm going to explain how easy it is to carry out your activities here in the Google Classroom. So once you have joined your Google Classroom, I'm looking at 1D at the moment, but the same goes for 1C as well. So you will find there are two in your stream area. You will find there are two activities. One is the writing activity and the other one is the speaking activity. So both have access. Both of these activities have links to the Google document, which we'll look at in a moment, and the password protected Padlet. So let's have a look at the Padlet quickly. Here it is. On the Padlet, you'll find the speaking and writing activity instructions. And this is what your posts will look like. They will look like these, and they'll be as big or as small as as you make them. Basically, you'll write your name and surname. You do not have to create an account with the Padlet. Just come in, and up here you'll see anonymous instead of my name or your name. So that's why I want you to write your name and surname straight away. You don't have to write the class because we know each class will have their own Padlet. And then in this, leave the speaking activity. You can actually copy the post. If you click on here, the three dots, the menu, you'll be able to change a color, edit the post, or copy the post. You can actually copy the post. And then, or the easiest, if you want to create your own, is just to double click and there you'll be able to write on it and then attach files or copy your answer here. So that's the Padlet and it's fairly easy to see. Now we'll go over to back to the classroom. Once you've done the work anyway, what I want you to do is actually submit it. But you will make sure you do submit exactly the writing activity and the writing activity and the speaking activity and the speaking activity. Let's take a look at the Google document now. So here it is here, and what I've done is I've scanned the actual two pages from the textbook just so you have it in front of you in case you want to work and you don't have your textbook open. Then, once you've carried out all the activities, the speaking activity and the writing activity, this is basically what you have to do for your assignment in the Google Classroom. So one is the speaking activity and the other one is the writing activity. Now, both you can actually use internet and do some research if you like. I'll show you what I've done. And then once you've done both of these, there'll be another assignment in your Google Classroom, which will be titled Oral Presentation. Once you have given your oral presentation, then I will give you permission to submit your work and then the mark will show up. Okay, this is an example of a speaking activity. So you would write speaking activity by your name and surname. And I've used a table. Houses in the UK and houses in Italy. The writing activity, again, writing activity by your name and your surname. And I've written something about the Marche region. I've used images that I've put in the links where I took the images from, which is really important, and also the links that I used to write the fact file. The oral presentation can be one or both of the writing or speaking, and this is just a copy of what you see in the Google assignments. And that's it. It's really easy. You can actually, what you can do if you like, is create a Google document. You can actually copy this Google document into your own drive. You can use it as a basis. You can create another document. You'll find here all the outline and the headings that'll take you directly there. So if you want to see the examples, etc. Okay, that's it. Really easy, simple. And if you have any questions, remember you can ask me in the stream in the Google Classroom. See you in class.